absurd. It's just, it's a non-serious letter. It's full of typos. It's hyperbolic. It's unprofessional. Most of the letter has no medical meaning. It links to a website that doesn't exist. If he was elected, Donald Trump would be the oldest person to ever be sworn in as president. Whether or not he would try to make Hillary Clinton's health the issue, doesn't he owe it to the American people to release an actual medical report, a more credible, more complete statement?
It was a teenage wedding and the old folks wished him well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, said the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. They furnished off an apartment with a two-room robot sale. The coolerator was crammed with TV dinners and ginger ale. But when Pierre found work, the little money coming worked out well. C'est la vie, said the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. They had a hi-fi phone, oh boy, did they let it blast. 700 little records, all rock, rhythm, and jazz. But when the sun went down, the rapid tempo of the music fell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. They bought a souped-up chitney, was a cherry red 53. And drove it down to Orleans to celebrate the anniversary. It was there where Pierre was waiting to the lovely mademoiselle. C'est la vie, said the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. Truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, said the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell.